Middlesbrough, Nottingham Forest, Sheffield Wednesday, our main games tonight. And as usual, we'll have highlights from all the other Premier League matches played today. Alan and Gary will have their points of view, of course. And then after the football, it's fight time. Barry McGuigan used to be our state-of-the-art world featherweight champion. We have Paul Hodkinson. Some good judges think he's at least as good as McGuigan. And tonight he makes his second defence of the WBC World Featherweight Championship. Hodkinson's opponent, Fabrice Benichou of France, the current European champion. The big fight is in Toulouse and it follows the football. Right, tonight's WBC Featherweight Championship in Toulouse, something that Paul Hodkinson hasn't gone there to do, if you get my drift. Hodkinson has a good claim to be Britain's best current world champion. He beat a top Mexican, Marcus Villasana, to win the title and retained it against an outclassed Steve Cruz of America back in April.
That's a good left hook from Hodkinson. Delayed action. Hard punch. The second time the challenger visits the canvas. This is the third round, and his eyes have gone, his eyes are screwed up as though he can no longer see.
Hodkinson's opponent tonight, Fabrice Benichou of France, the current European champion, seen here defeating British fighter John Davison. So it's Hodkinson versus Benichou, the WBC World Featherweight title at stake. It's scheduled for 12 rounds, and at ringside is Harry Carpenter.
So now we're only a few moments away from the second defence of the WBC Featherweight title by Paul Hodkinson. And it looks on paper like a pretty tough job against this man, the European Featherweight champion. This man has had seven previous world title fights and won three of them. He is the former IBF super bantamweight champion, or if you prefer, the light featherweight champion. So Hodkinson has got a lot on his plate, one suspects, tonight. Here's the referee, Franz Marti from Switzerland. He will control the fight, but outside the ring are three judges who will score it. And here's a little sort of summary of their pluses and minuses. So Hodkinson's up on speed and punch and technique and bravery. So now the referee calls the two men together. 12 rounds with Hodkinson coming from the right defending this WBC title. His 23rd professional fight tonight. Only one defeat. Judges from Belgium, Spain and Italy. And so with French cheers ringing around this ring, we're in an ice rink in a suburb of Toulouse called Blagnac, which is in fact the centre of the aerospace industry here. This is where Concorde was born and where the European Airbus comes from. Hodkinson in the red trunks. There'll be quite a considerable amount of concern in the Hodkinson corner about his eyes. They're always vulnerable. They tend to swell quite easily and early on. Benichou looking more like a judo man than a boxer with the way his hair is done up. Or am I thinking of a sumo man? Hodkinson looking menacing as he moves forward with the jab and the right cross. Well covered up against the counters. Hodkinson quite threatening with the right hand, even this early. Wearing the legend Hoko, that's his nickname, wearing it at the front of his trunks. He's about an inch taller than his French opponent. 5'4", Hodkinson. Hodkinson whipping out some quite fast, useful looking punches, but at the same time occasionally taking the right counter. A little bit of puffiness already beginning to appear at the left eye of Hodkinson. This was expected, and there'll be a lot of work being done in that corner with the ice. A lively opening. There's the bell to end the first round. Pretty active first 3 minutes. Well, as I told you, I've got Colin McMillan, the WBO featherweight champion, sitting right here alongside me. Welcome, Colin. What do you think of that for a start?
I thought that was a very good round for Paul. I think he established control and he connected with quite a few good fellow punches, and I think he got Benichou's respect very early on.
They went off at a fair old pace, didn't they, for a 12-round fight?
They did. They're from the same mould of school of thought, so I think it's going to be that kind of fight all the way through.
Do you think this is likely to go all the way or not?
With Paul's eyes held out, hopefully he should stop Benichou by the later part of the fight. That's how he's looking at the moment anyway.
Right. Would you care to meet Hodkinson? Is that on the cards for you? You'd like to do that?
Definitely. We're trying to get that fight lined up for any time next year.
Right. Well, I hope it comes off for you.
Head away.
Okay. Here's some replay from that opening round with Benichou trying to throw the counters, but not looking quite as effective as Hodkinson. Hodkinson from Kirby. His second defense of this title. First defense a few months ago in Belfast against Steve Cruz, the American who took the WBA title, featherweight title, away from Barry McGuigan a few years ago. But he wasn't the same Steve Cruz the night he fought Hodkinson, and Hodkinson got rid of him very easily indeed. Stopped in 3 rounds. This could be a little harder. Hodkinson trying to put Benichou under considerable pressure in these opening moments. Has been European champion at two weights. He was European bantamweight champion 4 years ago. Now he holds the featherweight title. He's had two extremely hard fights with Britain's John Davison. Caution there to Hodkinson to keep his punches up. Hodkinson's still punching sharply. Good, crisp-looking punching. And Hodkinson backing his man up all the time. Hodkinson varying his work to head and body. Looks sharp. Good right hand. Just a bit far back. Already is proving to be the sort of fight we thought it would be. Hard and fast. Plenty of action. But Hodkinson, for my money, looks the more competent of the two men, the better technician. I don't know whether Colin agrees with that.
Yeah, he defends himself really well. Officially left hook downstairs, I think it's given Benichou a lot of problems, and he's looking as though he's blown already.
He's determined to keep the Frenchman under pressure and force him battle with that, isn't he?
That's what he's really got to do. Benichou being short, you would have thought he would have tried to take the initiative and take the inside, but I think Paul's too strong for him now.
Do you think Benichou is not such a good fighter going back, perhaps?
I don't think so. The style that he's got, I think he's better suited to get, you know, in fighting, getting involved. And with Paul, who's got the harder punch, he's not able to do that.
Right. So, not too bad a start from Britain's point of view.
No, it's a great start.
Good. So round three coming up. This is round two action. Good right hand there from Hodkinson. It landed just a little bit far back on the jaw. Otherwise it might have done a lot more damage. Frenchman in the white trunks has been a pro since 1984, 44 professional fights, twice as many as Hodkinson, 33 wins, he's lost 11 and he's been stopped three times, but he's fought in good class all the way along. Seven world title fights before this, it's an extraordinary record, and six European championships, he's won five of those. Again, Hodkinson goes for the head, then quickly switches to the body. The British champion's face set like a mask, impassive, very determined looking. Nicely guarded with the right hand then. Again, keeping the Frenchman under constant pressure. Thing that the Frenchman has actually done a lot of work in the Hodkinson camp in Belfast. He trained for one of his world title, in fact when he won the world title from Jose Sanabria, he trained for that fight in Belfast in Hodkinson's own gym. Although Hodkinson has never sparred with him, in fact told me he'd never seen him before he came here, although they worked in the same gym. Getting a little bit of signalling from his corner to keep coming on. He's just slowed down slightly in this round. Just a slight puffiness around the left eye of Hodkinson. It's nothing serious. Were fierce exchanges at the end of that round, and they both felt each other's punches, and one or two very hard punches exchanged there in those last 10 seconds.
Definitely the big shots are definitely flying in now, and Paul's got to be careful. He's not you know, dragged into a dogfight, and be careful of that head.
Yeah, make sure the guy fight his fight head, rather than get drawn into that sort of thing.
That's right. Still doing the right thing, though.
Just the beginning of a swelling now coming on the face of Hodkinson. In fact, they're working underneath the right eye. This is Benichou. Born in Madrid and had his first pro fight in Italy in 1984 and then boxed in Venezuela, Panama, the United States. At one time he was the amateur champion of Israel. He really has had a bizarre career. That was a tremendously good right hand from Hodkinson at the end of that third round. Franz Marti, Swiss referee, calling them together for round number four. Hodkinson, the world champion, in the red trunks. It's an extraordinary thing. There are four recognised world champions at this weight. WBA, WBC, IBF and WBO. We've got three of them in this arena tonight. There's Hodkinson, of course, there's Colin sitting next to me. And the IBF featherweight champion has fought here tonight in a non-title fight and won. Manuel Medina from Mexico. Colin's had a good look at him. They might meet one day, you never know. Benichou just being allowed to do perhaps a little too much work. Taking the initiative slightly away from Paul here. Again, these rattling exchanges inside. Wild right hand, but it still caught Hodkinson on the top of the head. And this is really being fought at a very fast pace indeed. And Benichou is beginning to score quite heavily. Very hard to get some punches together, but the counter punches, not bad punches, are coming from the Frenchman. And Hodkinson getting picked off as he comes forward. That was better. And he has gone down. I thought at first it was a slip, but he's been hurt. I think he's winded. He's been caught to the body almost certainly. Well winded. Round four. Hodkinson suddenly has dramatic success. And he's following it up. And suddenly Benichou looks desperately in trouble. It's some fight. And Benichou has come back very gamely indeed from that. Benichou at one stage in that round was taking the initiative completely away from Hodkinson and was countering quite well until suddenly he went down for what I suspect must have been a body punch. It was over on the other side of the ring and there was a flurry of exchanges. He looked totally winded. But he got up gamely and came back. We'll see it here. Well, that was a tremendous left hook to the head. Well, it certainly wasn't the case of body punches, it was all head punches. And that was quite a battering the Frenchman took, Colin. That was, I'm surprised he came back so well from that.
Yeah, just when it looked like Paul was losing control, he came out with a couple of tremendous left hooks, and I think they took the win right out of Benichou and put him all kind of problems.
Right. So, Hodkinson's fourth round without any question. Been an exciting and good fight from the first bell. The corner keeping the swelling on Hodkinson's face well under control. He's had far worse trouble than this in fights with the swelling. Benichou again trying to box on the retreat. Benichou constantly looks to the corner. I don't know what sort of advice he hopes to get from there. Another good right hand from Hodkinson. There's a slippery patch in the centre of that ring where that sign is. And one or two of the boxers here tonight have slipped at that point. Well, all the experience that Benichou has gained from all those world title fights certainly being brought to bear in this fight. And although he was badly hurt in the fourth, he's still very strong. So again, Benichou not having a bad round after all the trouble he was in. Much closer run. And Benichou getting the better of it at the end. They're fighting this at, even for featherweights, they're going at a very strong pace here, aren't they?
Yeah, a very fast pace. I think, both of them are going to need to slow down in the next few rounds because they can't maintain this kind of pace.
Yeah, I was going to ask you that. It seems to me they're putting so much into these early rounds that they'll never get through 12 rounds at this pace.
I don't think so. But Paul's still doing the right thing. He's still applying that constant pressure. And I think Benichou is still looking, very uncomfortable.
But he came back quite well again, Benichou, there, didn't he? He was getting better at most of those exchanges.
Yeah, he's a game guy. He's always said that. We've always said that. He's a game guy. And he's always been there. But I think this constant pressure which Paul's applying will pay dividends in the next three or four rounds.
Might come down to who's got the better stamina in the end.
Could well do.
So, fast-paced, exciting WBC championship fight at featherweight. 9 stone. Hodkinson the champion. Benichou in the white trunks. The challenger. So we're rapidly approaching the halfway stage. Scheduled for 12. Hodkinson goes straight to work. Hodkinson, the former British and European featherweight champion. Only one man has ever beaten him as a pro. And that's the former world champion, Marcus Villasana. They had two fights. Hodkinson lost the first when he looked like winning it, but the eyes beat him. In the second fight, he came through a tremendous battle and won on points. That's the only previous time he's gone 12 rounds. Caution about the head to the challenger. And this French crowd really doing their best to lift Benichou. And still the pattern, much the same. Benichou under pressure, but still working with the jab principally and the occasional right swing. Trying to keep Hodkinson out as the champion moves in. Takes a deep breath, Benichou. Under fierce pressure again here. Hodkinson again, forward, forward all the time. Good right. The man takes a punch very well. But there are some very sharp punches coming here from Hodkinson. And they're rocking Benichou. But he's still gamely battling back. This really is some fight. All good punches from Hodkinson, and Benichou's in trouble again. He was in trouble in the fourth, and now towards the end of the sixth, he's in real trouble again. Where he finds the strength from to keep coming back, I don't know, 1 minute you think he's beaten, and then suddenly he starts punching again. So for the second time in this fight, Fabrice Benichou, the French challenger, has found himself in serious trouble against the ropes. But again, Hodkinson couldn't finish him off. What about it, guys? It really is a great fight, isn't it?
A cracking fight.
Did you think that he might have had in there? He was really getting some very hard punches across to Benichou.
Someone like Benichou is very durable. Yeah. It's going to take, you know, a certain amount of time for him to actually, you know, wear him down and take control. Paul has said before, he's doing the right thing. He's just been applying that constant pressure for another round or so, and I think he should take control.
And keep his fingers crossed that the eyes hold up all right.
That's right.
That's always a problem.
They're looking good at the moment. No problem to, you know, too severe. So, keep your fingers crossed.
Those were the moments at the end of the sixth when Benichou looked as though he might be beaten. But here he is coming out to start the second half of this championship. You wonder how much longer Benichou can keep coming back under this incessant assault. He's still slinging punches gamely. But again, the punches are raining in on him, and Hodkinson still keeping them short and sharp. Hodkinson well covered up against those replies. Most of them are landing on his arms. Well, what a difference this fight is from the one that Hodkinson had a few months ago in Belfast with Cruz. That really wasn't any fight at all, because Cruz shouldn't have been in there. This man has every right to be in there, Benichou. He's a good, game, courageous opponent. And he's not beaten yet. Hodkinson must be beginning to wonder what's holding him up. Benichou's arms coming down. Again he tries to put the right counter across. Trapped on the ropes again, this is where he gets into trouble. Good punches again. Half a dozen of them there from Hodkinson, all going through. And still the man won't go. Wonderful courage. He's bringing this French crowd to its feet, Benichou, with this extraordinary display of gameness. And I would think the Hodkinson corner are praying that he gets rid of him soon. These two men, Colin, must have trained extremely well for this. They couldn't put on this sort of fight the way it's been going.
Yeah, I can't believe it. It's a tremendous pace. I would have thought by now one or two of them would have been feeling the pace, but they, you know, both still come out there throwing good, strong, hard punches.
See, Hodkinson's fighting a very good fight, and yet he's still got the man to beat, hasn't he? You know, it's not over yet.
That's right. I think Benichou's still showing a lot of desire. But I don't think Paul could have actually hoped for anything better than the way things have went tonight.
Right. No, he's a long way in front, obviously. He's attacked from beginning to end. Do you still fancy a fight with him?
Definitely.
Come on, be honest.
Definitely.
It'd be a good match,
shouldn't it? I must admit, he's looking good tonight.
The stars would work together, wouldn't we? Your artistry and his
boxer and a fighter.
Yeah.
It'd be great.
Yeah. Five rounds to go in this WBC Featherweight Championship here just outside Toulouse in the south of France. Very close to the Pyrenees. Had several cautions, Hodkinson, about his head. Hodkinson looks momentarily as though he might be in a little bit of trouble. He certainly can't afford to relax against this man. He's making the referee hop about a bit lively. Hodkinson tries to work him towards the ropes again. The two really bad patches for Benichou have both come when he's been on the ropes. He looks to his corner again. Still a long way to go. What a good right hand Benichou's thrown, and Hodkinson is in trouble. Absolutely shook it. And now suddenly the whole thing is turned around. The boot truly on the other foot now, with Hodkinson having to show courage to come back from that. Jolted right down to his heels by a right hand. But he's come through it well. My word, he needed to be fit to survive that one. Benichou has gained a lot in confidence from that. Oh, punches back from Hodkinson. This thing swinging backwards and forwards now. And Hodkinson comes back and finishes the round on top. But my word, he really did get a nasty shot there. Where did that right hand come from, Colin?
I didn't think coming either.
that was a bit of a setback there. No argument about it.
Everything looked to be going fine for Paul when he walked onto the shot. He's got to make sure he doesn't get careless there.
It was a socking right hand. Look at that. It almost turned him over. And he did well to come back as strongly as he did from that.
You've got to admire Benichou's resilience. I mean, he's taken some shots early on in the fight, and he still came back for a beautiful right hand. Nearly turned up the fight all the way around.
Yep. So, 8 rounds completed. And the thing still in the balance. If Benichou can still do things like that, he's still got a big chance. And the referee asking, indicating a tee, asking for time off while they wipe some water up from the French corner. And Benichou is an altogether more confident character now. Sometimes you look at Benichou and you think, well, he's at the end of his tether. He looks flat-footed. His sudden hands come down. He looks slow. And then, wham, out comes some good punches. Both of them undoubtedly feeling the pace now. The pace has slowed down considerably. Hardly surprising. Question now, where's the next big one coming from? Which side? Good right from Hodkinson. Beautiful short little right cross. Benichou takes a punch so well. Hodkinson certainly feeling the pace. He can no longer keep up the non-stop assault. Coming down to raw guts now in this. Hodkinson scowls, pitches his pants up and goes back in. Benichou's tape for coming loose from the glove. So there'll be time off for this. I wouldn't think either of them will begrudge a little respite here. It's hard going. And Hodkinson clearly must be wondering what's holding the man up. He's hit him with everything he's got, and still Benichou looks dangerous. Still giving Hodkinson more trouble than enough. Another good little short, stropped right hand on the chin of Benichou, who takes it. And again looks desperately tired as he goes back to the corner. But he still looks like a dangerous man to me.
He does indeed. I mean, every so often he comes out with a dangerous leaping right hand, and Paul's got to be careful he doesn't connect. I think they're both feeling the pace at the moment. He slowed down a little bit,
Hodkinson has set up a big lead, obviously, in the early stage of it. I think it's beginning to be whittled down a bit now because the guy's taken the play away from him.
That's right. Paul's got to be careful he doesn't become dispirited. I mean, he's thrown all his best shots, and Benichou is eventually still there, and he's still looking quite strong, so Paul's got to be careful that he doesn't, you know, psychologically start faltering.
And somehow, it's a harder fight than you'd won, didn't it?
Definitely.
So, on we go with this extraordinary championship here in France. Hodkinson battling to keep his WBC featherweight title against a very, very strong and useful opponent from France, Fabrice Benichou, in the white trunks. Benichou's been in real trouble once. Hodkinson's been in trouble once. And you get the feeling it's still all there to go for. Benichou, mouth coming open, looks very tired, but you can't tell with this man. He might suddenly pull something out of a bag yet. I think the two of them are very near exhaustion. Benichou has got a cut mouth. He's got a rather nasty looking cut on the upper lip. And Hodkinson might be feeling that his moment is coming. Benichou looks in real trouble. Mouth open, mouth cut, desperately tired, still trying to do something. You won't see any more courageous fighter than this. Benichou swallowing blood. He's in real trouble. And the referee is calling for the doctor to come and look at this cut. It's a very nasty looking cut on the top lip. And there'll be eruptions here if the doctor decides he can't continue. I think it may be called off. Franz Marti taking him back to his own corner, and I think he's telling them that he's going to have to be withdrawn from the fight. And he is. Benichou, so unluckily, has been forced out of the fight with that ugly cut on the top lip, leaving Hodkinson still the WBC featherweight champion. And it's an unhappy ending to what was a tremendous battle, and it was the worst possible way it could finish after all the tremendous action there'd been. But Benichou was in trouble, he was hurt, he was swallowing blood, and there can't be much doubt that the decision to pull him out was right. Would you agree with that, Colin?
Yeah, but it's always a shame to see a fight like that end the way it did. I think for both fighters, they both finished their pride intact, but you know, you sometimes like to see a fight, a world title fight, finish a little bit more conclusively.
Yeah. I think Hodkinson was...
I think he dominated the fight, and shown he was the superior fighter.
But, as you say, an unhappy way for a tremendous championship to finish. Two men who'd pretty well given their all in that. And then the cut mouth brought it all to a sudden and unfortunate end. You can see that diagonal cut on the left-hand side of his top lip. So, Benichou beaten, Hodkinson the winner, but I wouldn't mind betting they'll be pleased for a return, and certainly the French crowd will want to see the two men fight again. Paul, congratulations. Do you feel strong enough to speak to me?
Oh, yeah. As you say, you know, we were both tired, you know, but I think I was finishing a little bit stronger at the end there, you know.
You must have been glad to get rid of him because he was some tough customer.
Yeah, I knew he was tough, you know. I got, you know, he was a lot awkward than what I thought he was, you know. It was very hard to catch clean, you know. He was awkward and very strong, you know. Maybe it wasn't as fit as what I thought it was, you know.
You weren't fit? You looked fit to me.
I was fit, like, but maybe it wasn't one of my best performances, you know. You know, and that's
you amaze me.
Yeah, but I'm never happy anyway, you know. But it was a very tough opponent, you know. And we were both tired. Well, I was tired, but I think I was finishing a little bit.
You looked
strong.
As though you had him going the fourth and then again in the sixth. Were you surprised he came through that?
Well, he's very tough, you know, very durable, you know. Yeah, I caught him with a good shot. I think what was it, overhand right, was it?
He also caught you with a very good shot, the right hand in the eighth.
To be honest, he never hit me at all.
It didn't look like that from where I was sitting.
He could maybe caught me flush on, but, you know, he didn't. When he had caught me a good shot, you know, that was a good shot. But, you know, my senses were there. I knew what I was doing.
It was a tremendous fight, but it was just a pity that it had to end the way it did because it was a bit of an anticlimax when he got the cut.
Yeah, it was a bad cut. They said it was a class event, but I don't know, you know.
It was a bad cut, wasn't it?
It was a bad cut. The lip was split, you know, but I think I was finishing it stronger towards the end there, you know. I don't know, he might have hung in, but, you know, I might stop him towards the end, you know.
Now, BJ's, we haven't got that one out of the way. What's next for Paul?
Well, strangely enough, the promoter, Mr. Roger Ferrer, is just after making us an offer if we'd come back before Christmas in a fight against anybody in the top 10. He's informed us that the French television are very interested in showing him again. They were delighted with the showing tonight.
Now, I've been working with Colin McMillan, the WBO champion, and he's very keen to have a go at Paul. What do you think?
Well, I'm sure that may be so, and Colin will get his chance, but he'll have to wait.
Is there going to be a return with Benichou, do you think?
I think that automatically there'll be a return, I think, maybe in the new year sometime, but obviously it'll take 5 or 6 months for that cut to heal up.
Okay.
And my boy's looking sharp and well, not a mark on him.
All your family here tonight, Paul?
Yeah,
they're proud of you.
I'm proud of everyone, you know. I just like to thank all the supporters who turned up tonight from Great Britain. And, you know, they've really put me through there.
Right. Well, you can take that cup and the belt back to Kirby and Belfast. Well done, mate.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, right. Colin, we've just seen a tremendous scrap there. What are your thoughts about it all at the end?
I thought a great performance by Paul. He done, you know, everything expected of him, and I don't think he could actually done any better than he did.
The amazing thing is he's saying that he didn't feel he was completely fit. Now, he looked fit enough to us, didn't he?
He looked in remarkable condition to keep up that kind of, you know, pace for so long.
I would have thought he was well in front of the finish, wouldn't you?
Without a doubt, I think he won virtually all the rounds. Though a few of them were quite close, and one he got a little bit hurt. But apart from that, you know, he dominated the fight.
What chances do you think there are of your having a fight with Hodkinson?
Well, I've always said that, you know, I think he's a great champion, and I'd like to fight him to prove who's the best in Britain. Listening to Barney speak there, it doesn't appear as though, you know, they've got me in an immediate sight.
No.
But maybe I might have to go look elsewhere. I thought Manny Medina tonight, he'd another possibility. But as I've said before, my aim is to unify the titles, and come when what may, I'll fight Paul.
It's a fight all Britain would want to see, because with two Brits and two world titles at stake, I mean, that's got to sell, hasn't it?
I think it'd be a cracking fight. You know, I think the stars are made for it, and the public would enjoy it.
Colin, thanks for all your help tonight.
Thanks, Harry.
Thank you.
Well, I'd certainly like to see that one if it happens. I hope you've enjoyed this night of sport with us. A great fight, good football, good night.